We want to find the inverse of the function given here as a table. One way to think of an inverse function is a function that undoes
or performs the opposite operation of the original function.
So looking at function f, the x values are the inputs and the y values are the outputs. So when the input for function f is 1, the output is 2, which means for the inverse function, when the input is 2, the output is 1. Notice how the inverse function is undoing the operation of the original function. When the input is 4 for f, the output is negative 4. So when the input for f inverse is negative 4, the output is positive 4. So notice how the outputs for function f become the inputs for the inverse function, and the inputs for function f become the outputs for the inverse function. So if this is 9, 0, this is 0, 9. If this is 2, negative 2, this is negative 2, 2. If this is 7, 3, this will be 3, 7. If this is 3, negative 1, this is negative 1, 3. If this is 6, 4, this is 4, 6. And if this is 8, negative 3, this is negative 3, 8. The way we express this using function notation, if f of x is a 1 to 1 function, f of x equals y if and only if f inverse of y equals x. Again, x is the input into our function f. Y is the output of function f, which becomes the input into the inverse function, which returns the original value of x. So these two functions undo each other. One other nice way to show this is to map this relationship. So for example, here's our function f. Again, when the input is x, the output is y, and this becomes the input into the inverse function, which returns the output of the original value of x. So again, we can see these two functions, if they're inverses, undo each other. I hope you found this helpful.